On this next use case, we'll talk about network planning and change management. And this is where a lot of our, especially our utility customers, give us very positive feedback around being able to not only understand, as we did before, the paths and the asymmetric issues, but then to be able to plan. I need to, those networks are always changing, they're always adding new devices, they need to understand what those impacts will be and make sure that it doesn't cause asymmetric paths or cause other kinds of latency issues in their network. Here in this particular case, let's go back to that example where we had a particular failure here at the adjacency there in Chicago causing that strange routing out to LA. I'm actually going to pull us into topology planning mode. And what that does is that I'm now using that live network at that time to simulate changes. So in this case, I'm going to add a link. I want to add a link between LA and JFK here to improve my resilience. I've engineered this. I want to see what the impact would be if I turn up this link. So I'm scheduling some time to put up a link. I've selected these two points here, and I'm going to hit the next button, and it actually creates that link. We can actually see the impact to the path that that has. Now notice here, we're looking at kind of an interesting impact here. We've got the forward direction has changed and now taking that shorter path, but the return direction hasn't. Now we've got a very big asymmetric path difference here that could cause all kinds of issues for, you know, latency issues for all of the control systems. We can actually see here, now we're still modeling, so I can do show impact, and it'll actually tell me what number of prefixes, what number of links have changed, so I can actually see and notice, is there a difference? You know, what is the difference? What is the number of hops? So I can actually, before I make the change in the real network, understand what the number of hops, the latency issues, the changes in metric that may impact all the routing in my network before it's deployed. Here in this case, I can see that, yes, there is an issue. That'll take me back to my planning mode here. And I'll go, okay, I need to take care of this tunnel. I need to make sure that that tunnel is configured with a hard path for recovery, that I now change that so that it will take my secondary link and I'll have the required result by adding that link. So I'm going to do that here, edit my link, and then apply for that particular tunnel, and then we'll see that, in fact, as long as I do this change management window with the addition of the link and the editing of the configuration on that LAXP 102 to make sure that that tunnel is correctly configured, then I will have the expected results and have my low latency path added back into my network. This is one that our customers, especially in the utilities industry, is used very frequently, just because, as you mentioned earlier, you know, the criticality of these networks, adding a link or taking a link down and being able to understand what customers or services are impacted is absolutely critical. And how that relates to other failures in the network. If you've got a link down, in this case, we've got a couple of other adjacencies down, your network is now doing things that you hadn't necessarily planned for. Now let's edit and see how it responds when I make some changes before I make them. That way I'm not bringing down, you know, different substations or having an impact on different capabilities within the network.